new band of rebels arose who were determined to carry the fight to Jerusalem.
The Sicarii.
To the Sicarii, anyone who wasn't fighting the Romans was a collaborator and worthy of death.
Many were slain every day, and the fear many were in was worse than the calamity itself.
To Yahweh Shimei El Shai. All right, we're the Hebrew Israelites of the set of Sicarii, Seattle. All right, we want to touch on the fact that, you know, you got this fool in the office, Donald Trump, man, causing all kinds of ruckus with our people. You know what I'm saying? Talking about he's going to build a border, you know, to keep the so-called Hispanics out. Saying that he signed the executive order to have that pipeline, the work of that pipeline to continue. You know what I'm saying? And all these things, man, the Lord is moving right now, man. He's moving throughout 2017, just in this month alone, man. You know what I'm saying? But it's high time for our people to understand, you know what I'm saying, the type of oppression that our people have been taking, man, by this damn devil, by the so-called white, all right? And that's why, man, we give all praises to the Lord, man, for putting that damn cracker in office, man. You know what I'm saying? By putting him in office to stir up, to rise up, you know, the spirits of our people, man. So our people can wake the hell up out here, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because the Lord does not want our people, you know what I'm saying, to be mingled amongst these heathens, man. He wants us to be together, man, as one nation like we used to at one point in time, man. All right? The 12 tribes of Israel, speaking of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians, man. Go ahead and get what you got. Verse 1. Slide.
This is the book of Genesis, chapter 11, the first verse. It says, and the whole earth was of one language.
Right. At one point, the whole earth was of one language, man. Speaking what? Hebrew, man. All right? Not speaking all these different languages that you see before you to this very day. All right? Go ahead.
It says, and of one speech, and it came to pass, as they journeyed from the east, that they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there. It says, and they said one to another, go to let us make brick and burn them thoroughly.
Really?
It says, and they had brick for stone, and slime had they for mortar. It says, and they said, go to let us build us a city and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven.
Right, man. You know what I'm saying? And this whole philosophy of world domination, a new world order, a one world government.
Nothing new,
man. And like the scriptures say, it says that the Lord does not change. Okay, the Lord doesn't change of having all these different nations to be mingled amongst each other. But the nations, at one particular point in time, wanted to come together and exalt themselves against the Heavenly Father, man. You know what I'm saying? And in doing so, the Lord divided the nations. Okay, and that's what this scripture is speaking on. Going all the way back to Shinar, which is Babylon. Now, go ahead.
It says, verse 5, and the Lord came down to see the city and right. The tower, which the children of men builded. It says, and the Lord said, behold, the people is one, and they have one language, and this they will begin to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them, which they have imagined to do.
Right, man. You know what I'm saying? So having all these people mingling together, man, all it is an antichrist spirit. You know what I'm saying? That those peoples had back then, which is the same spirits reincarnated to this very day now, man. Want to exalt themselves against the Father, man. Want to take out the angel. That's why they got all these different tactics, man. You know what I'm saying? All these different things conjured up together, you know what I'm saying? All these different nations to build up the weapons to fight against the angel and our Lord, who you call Jesus Christ. We know it's Yahweh Shai in ancient Hebrew, man. To fight against him and the angel and the chariots, man. All right? But that same philosophy, that same mentality, stems all the way back to Babylon. Yeah. Go ahead.
And they said, Verse 7. Go to let us go down, and there confound their language, that they may not understand one another's speech.
Right, and the Lord sent his angels, all right, the Lord allowed this to happen, you know, to allow that division to take place, man. You know what I'm saying? To divide the language. Divide, that's why the Lord set up division amongst all the nations. We're going to get that, though, but keep reading.
It says, so the Lord scattered them abroad from thence upon the face of all the earth.
Right.
And they left off to build the city. It says, therefore is the name of it called Babel, because the Lord did confound the language of all the earth. And from thence did the Lord scatter them abroad upon the face of the earth.
Right, man. The Lord scattered all the nations abroad upon the face of the earth, man. That's what the word Babylon means. Babel, confusion, man. We brought confusion. You know what I'm saying? Because it's confusion even in of itself to have all these nations as one, man. To have all these nations mingled amongst each other. That's, you know what that's called? It's called madness, man. Mingling cultures together like that, man. You know what I'm saying? That's just like having different clothes, man. Like having orange shoes, a red shirt, a white hat, in blue jeans, man. Confusion, madness, man. Go ahead.
It says, these are the generations of Shem.
Oh, so like, go ahead and get what is that? Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 8. You know what I'm saying? Because what we establishing today is the fact that the Lord has always had the philosophy of division amongst the nations. All right, separation amongst the nations. All right, and the Lord doesn't want our people mingling amongst these damn heathens. The white man, the Arab, the Chinese, the Japanese, all these different damn Gentiles, man, that the Lord does not care for. Okay, go ahead.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32 and 8th verse. It says, when the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance, when he separated the sons of Adam.
Right, when he divided the nations to their inheritance, gave them different lands, gave them different languages, you know, later on, speaking to the sons of Adam, all right, he divided them there and gave them their land and language, all right, gave them their particular portion, all right, he separated, keep reading.
It says, he separated the sons of Adam, talks a lot, when the Most High divided to the nations their inheritance, when he separated the sons of Adam, he set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel.
Right, he set the bounds according to the number of the children of Israel. Who are the children of Israel? You Negroes, you Hispanics, you Native American Indians. You make up the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. Right? Your portion is his portion, or his portion is you, no? All right, the Lord looks, when he looks at all these different nations, he looks at you as the apple of his eye. Why? Because he sees a reflection of it, of the apple of his eye. Speaking of his pupil, he's seeing a reflection of himself, man. Because he made the nation of Israel to be one nation, to be one nation to himself, man. Keep reading.
He says, for the Lord's portion is his people. Jacob is the lot of his inheritance.
Right, Jacob is a lot of his inheritance, man. All right, no other particular nation on this planet outside of the nation of Israel.
Are you guys what they call, is it like the Black Hebrews movement or the Black
Israelites? Well, first I have to correct you. We're not the Black Hebrew Israelites, we're the Hebrew Israelites, okay?
You also.
So, no, it's all good. What we out here, you know what I'm saying, what we do out here every week is to teach the Negroes, Hispanics and Native American Indians that they're God's chosen people. So what that does is that cuts that whole ideology of what people like to put stigma on us as Black Hebrew Israelites, okay? Because according to the Bible, these people on this 12 tribes sign make up the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel, all right? So when you deal with, because really when you deal with like those so-called Jews over there in Israel, they don't call themselves Hebrew Israelites, like it tells you in the Bible. Okay, Israelites, they call themselves Israelis, all right? They call themselves Jewish instead of Jew, okay? So that's what we teach. That's what we teach up here. So do you have any other further questions?
No, that's all.
All right.
Keep it real.
Well, that's what we do. Bible's written.
Yeah.
Go ahead. That's it. Yeah. So the Most High, man, he just like it. The Most High has always had the nation of Israel.
Take a picture of you guys?
No. Well, now don't take a picture of us, but you can take the picture of the sign.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. Yeah, man. So the Most High, man, separated the sons of Adam, and Jacob was his portion, or Jacob was a lot of his inheritance, man. All right.
Hi.
Hey.
Hey, man. You guys come out today, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, man. I love going on YouTube and looking at the videos.
Oh, you do?
Man, the Israelites are so powerful. Don't none of this other stuff make no sense, but the Israelites. It makes sense.
But yeah, I mean, there's only one truth out there, bro. You know what I'm saying? You know, because if there was multiple truths, there'd be all. I could take some of this, take some of that.
It don't work that way.
It's confusing.
God ain't one way. Right. Ain't none of that.
Right.
Yeah.
What do you be watching? Just be watching anybody?
I watch different ones. I watch IUIC. Mm-hmm. I watch Brother Hashar, Harry 90 and GMS, different ones. Sakari, yeah.
Yeah, you like that?
I seen one with, I think Sakari got in a fight with somebody. Knocked these two white dudes. Yeah. And he knocked these two white dudes out. Yeah. They were standing there reading the Bible. The dude was just going off shit. The dude was just, the Israelites are very organized, Jack. They like it right here.
Yep.
As soon as he made a move, they stuck his ass.
That was a small.
Yeah. You did that to the Indians, Hispanics.
Yeah.
To the Israelites, I didn't realize. I heard a little sprinkling. I didn't realize that Hispanics and Indians were on the ships before we were.
Yeah.
And they don't even realize. A lot of them think they were never slaves.
Yeah,
because their language was forced on them.
Yeah, man, like when the Spanish ship from this came over to the island, like during over there, like Puerto Rico, Cuba, and whatnot. What the Spanish did was, you know what I'm saying, they ended up conquering them. They were shipping some of them to Spain as slaves, and what they did was they were parading around like, you know, like guards and shit, man, with no clothes and shit, humiliating.
What, you're Native?
Yeah, I'm Native.
You're Native? So you're God.
Yeah. But how you pronounce it is how you pronounce it in the Hebrew. God.
And it says in the end that you shall rule over your oppressor and put a silver iron on his neck and haul him back across the waters from which he hauled you from.
Yeah. Huh? Oh, you know what it is?
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 30 and verse 1. And it says, and it shall come to pass, when all these things are come upon thee, the blessing and the curse, which I have set before thee, and thou shalt call them to mind among the nations whither the Lord thy God hath driven thee. Because that's what we're doing right now. We're standing out here calling these things to mind among all the different nations and people that you see walking around. The blessing and the curse, both have already come to pass. Now this part's coming to pass. It says, and shall return unto the Lord thy God, and shall obey his voice according to all that I command thee this day, thou and thy children, with all thy heart and with all thy soul, that then the Lord thy God will turn thy captivity and have compassion upon thee, and will return and gather thee from all the nations whither the Lord thy God has scattered thee.
And that's exactly what's happening right now, because we're out throughout
the world. Israelite camps are popping up left and right.
All throughout the whole globe.
Exactly.
You know, so he's gathering all of us up from all these different nations and from all these different...
Israelites are right. He's saying, everyone's going to run back to their home. I look on the news, man. There's racial violence. The people, all this kind of shit going on, steaming up worse and worse and worse. And the Israelites is telling you too, you walking by, you ain't paying no attention.
It says in verse 4, if any of thine be driven out into the utmost parts of heaven, from thence will the Lord thy God gather thee, from thence will he bless thee. And the Lord thy God will bring thee into the land which thy fathers possessed, and thou shalt possess it, and he will do thee good, and
multiply thee above thy fathers, and the Lord thy God will circumcise thy heart and the heart of thy seed, to love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul that thou mayest live. Here's the point. It says, and the Lord thy God will put all these curses upon thy enemies, and them that hate thee, and was persecuted.
Right.
So every curse that we read about in Deuteronomy 28, when the Lord reverses our captivity and puts us back in the land, all those curses are hitting these guys. You know what I'm saying?
Yes. So, they ain't gonna be the trash of society, lower class, trading places.
Where it talks about you.
And Esau knows it because he make movies like Trading Places. See, with Eddie Murphy and Dan Aykroyd?
Yeah.
They took Eddie Murphy, a homeless, out of the mind guy, and made him the wealthy guy. And took the wealthy guy and made him the poor guy. Because they know in the end it's exactly what's going to happen.
You know, and that goes into the story of Lazarus. You ever heard of that story of Lazarus? That's the exact story that you said is the exact story that's written in the scripture. You know what I'm saying? The poor man and that rich man.
But you realize when you change it, he's not changing into something you, because that's how it started out. You was on the top, and these others was your slaves. But we wanted to mix with them and be friends and follow their custom. So God didn't say, you gonna follow them? I'll tell you what, they will make them lords over you. So now Jesus returned what he's doing, and actually straightened it back out. More bites, the Israelites, all these going to be.
Yes. Okay. So really, they're supposed to be our servant. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
That's why it says in Ecclesiastes the 10th chapter that I see servants upon horses. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
It said
servants upon horses.
Yeah. They turn princes into handmaids.
Yeah. Some
servants ride upon horses, and I see.
We're supposed to be the kings. That's why it says we are gods, you know what I'm saying? But we fall as one of the princes, you know what I'm saying? Right.
Yes. And this is the only thing for the war, the only thing I see that contain the Israelite woman is what she follows these laws in this book.
That's it.
You wouldn't be able to be married to them in this society here if they wouldn't follow the laws.
Yeah. Yeah. Have no child support and everything else.
Take care, folks.
Yo, son, you brother. Where were we, what was that?
I'm going to do that station, bro.
Okay. It was Deuteronomy 32:8, right?
Yeah.
Okay, get Malachi 3:6. You know what I'm saying? Because this is something that the Lord has always ordained, though. You know what I'm saying? But you know, knowing that these heathens, and even our people that have become like the heathens, you know what I'm saying? They were trying to establish something new, huh? But the Lord is slowly but surely putting that division back into the hearts of these damn people, you know? You know what I'm saying? All one nation under God and shit, you know? You know what I'm saying? Which they God is Satan. Okay, but these nations in this very country, which is a melting pot, is going to be split very soon. Oh, yeah.
This is the book of Malachi, chapter 3 and the 6th verse. It says, for I am the Lord, I change not.
You hear that? I am the Lord Yahweh, I change not. No? Okay, so back then, he didn't want nations to be mingled amongst each other. All right? So if he hasn't changed, that means that's still in effect to the very day. Okay. Go ahead.
Therefore, you sons of Jacob are not consumed.
Right. That's right. Though you're so, you sons of Jacob, you Negroes, Hispanics, Native American Indians, you are not consumed. Huh? You know what I'm saying? So the Lord only deals with you. Okay. Above all people on the face of the earth. Huh? What's that? Give me Deuteronomy 28:1. You know what I'm saying? Because shit, man, if you're a Negro and Hispanic and Native American Indian, you're supposed to be happy that Trump is in office, man. what I'm saying? Because what is it doing? It's furthering these prophecies to unfold, man. You know what I'm saying? It's furthering the prophecies, man. You know what I'm saying? And when these prophecies are fully fulfilled, that's when the whole of this world know that Jesus Christ, we know as Yahweh Shai, a black man from the tribe of Judah, will come and save us out of this captivity that we're currently in, man. Okay? Go ahead.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 1. It says, and it shall come to pass, and thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and do all his commandments which I command thee this day. It says, and the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all the nations on earth.
Right, man. The Lord, if we were to follow these laws, statutes, and commandments, man, you know what I'm saying? The Lord would set you Negroes, Hispanics, Native American Indians up above all people on the face of the earth, man. You know what I'm saying? And that's something that, since we have transgressed the law, since we have strayed away from the right way, okay, we have been destroyed. We are subservient to these damn people. Especially to our number one enemy, the so-called white man. You know what I'm saying? Give me Ecclesiastes 10 and 6. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, that's what's exalted right now, man. That's what's being exalted right now on this earth, man. This madness and this folly of everybody loving each other, everybody faking the fuck with each other, everybody wanting to be multicultural, especially in this goddamn city called Seattle, which is nothing but multiculturalism throughout this damn city, and different races, different nations mingling amongst each other. You know what I'm saying?
This is Ecclesiastes, chapter 10, verse 6. It says folly is set in great dignity.
Right, folly is set in great dignity, man. You know what I'm saying? Yo, you got people out here talking about all kinds of madness on Twitter, Facebook, shit that don't even got nothing to do with anything, man. Following the damn illusion that's in America's. Following these damn fools that you call celebrities, man. These different Hollywood stars and shit, man. It ain't got nothing to do with your own goddamn life or anything significant to life in and of itself, man. Go ahead.
It says, and the rich sit in a low place.
Right, the rich sit in low places, man. Okay. And that's, and who was that rich that sit in low places? The same people that is called niggas, spicks, and cunts, man. All right? Our people, the nation of Israel, man. Because we've been reduced to that very low estate, man. Go ahead.
It says, I have seen servants upon horses.
Right, the Lord has seen servants upon horses, man. You know what I'm saying? And who is those servants on horses? Mainly the so-called white men, because he's the one ruling right now. Esau, all right? The devil, according to the Bible. Keep reading.
It says, upon horses and princes walking as servants upon the earth.
Right, princes walking as servants upon the earth, man. You know what I'm saying? And who are those princes that's speaking of you Israelites, man? Speaking of you Negroes and Latinos, man. You sit at the low place, you're the ones being oppressed, you're the ones being subservient to your enemy, the damn white man, and these other nations as well, man. Okay? And that's what's being exalted. In the Most High, give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6. The Most High, he always has dealt with our nation. But because of our transgressions, we become subservient to these nations. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, you know, since we become subservient, we want to be like these damn Gentiles. We want to be like the so-called white people, who's nothing but a base man to begin with, a base nation of people. Esau is a base nation. But we want to be like Esau, man. Go ahead.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and the 6th verse.
Right.
It says, for thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy power.
Right. The Lord, we're a holy people unto the Lord thy power, man. All right. We're supposed to be a set apart nation. We're supposed to be set apart from amongst these nations. All right. We're supposed to be different from all these nations. We're supposed to be keeping these laws, statutes, and commandments in their culture and customs that our forefathers were given by Moses, man, by the Heavenly Father. Y'all say not following the ways of America. Okay, go ahead.
It says, the Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
Right, he's chosen you Negroes, Hispanics, Native American Indians to be a special people unto himself. Well, go ahead.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Hear that? Above all people upon the face of the earth. We're supposed to be set apart. We're supposed to be keeping these laws and commandments, which sets us apart from all these different nations. You know what I'm saying? Because the Lord does not deal with these other nations. You got a question for me?
You know who that guy is right here?
You know
who he is? Historically, yeah. He was a prince. Who basically murdered his
brother.
Brother?
Yeah, killed his brother.
And he laid himself killed. And he was a bisexual.
Yeah, he was.
He
was.
Oh, he had sex with his sister.
Oh. He had sex with his sister.
So he's bisexual too.
Yeah.
But I'm surprised. I couldn't think of his name off him.
Cesare
Borges.
Yep.
Cesare Borges. Yeah. You know? That guy during the time of the 1300s, during the Renaissance era, you know what I'm saying, the Borgia family conquered all different spots in, I believe, Byzantium, different parts of Europe. And they were putting up these damn, you know, images and erasing the original images over there.
Naturally, man.
You know?
God bless, keep you safe.
Yep.
See
you, brother. Is that dude on? Is that?
It's so damn funny, man.
That was in on Deuteronomy, though, right? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So we're supposed to be a set apart nation. You know what I'm saying?
And they expound on that, it says, above all people upon the face of the earth.
Right.
Which means that when Martin Luther King gave that speech about all men being created equal, that was a lie. And it also means if you're above everybody, you're not equal to anybody or below anybody. That means that the Lord has a hierarchy in how he deals with the nations on the planet earth.
Right. Yeah. I mean, but you know, it's funny that philosophy, that whole thing though, we see this in like different sports, we see this in different manager craftsmanship, whether it be business, whether it be sports, whether it be mechanics. You have average, you have bad, the mediocre, the average, the good, and the great. So if we know that there's a hierarchy, and there's levels to this thing in those particular places, how the hell is there not levels to different nations? You know what I'm saying? But see, with this philosophy that America pushes, you know what I'm saying, especially heaping all these nations amongst this particular nation, this particular country known as America, the USA, the United States of America, so-called, okay, they teach otherwise, yet they say that they believe in the Bible. You know what I'm saying? And then getting on the point of Martin Luther King, getting the fact on that guy, he never spoke any scripture. Huh? He never quote Bible, book, chapter, verse of any scripture in the Bible. So you know he was faking the funk. Huh? You know what I'm saying? He wasn't really no damn Christian. He didn't even really believe in the Bible. Okay? So, you know what I'm saying? And anybody pushing the doctrine is damn Antichrist. You don't believe in the scripture, you don't believe in Christ, you don't believe in the Heavenly Father. If you're not an Israelite, you don't even believe in the Heavenly Father, no damn. Okay? You got Malachi 3:6. Give me Sirach. Give me is that Sirach chapter 10? And I think it's verse 4. You know what I'm saying? Because you know these different nations, man, they're developing this great pride, man. You know what I'm saying? To bolt himself against the Heavenly Father, going directly against the scriptures, not something that they would do on accident or do by nature. They're doing it deliberately, you know? You know what I'm saying? It's because of that damn pride that's in their heart, you know? You know what I'm saying? Let's see who that's.
I don't know.
It's like 10 and 9. Now just want to read that one phrase.
This is the book of Sirach, chapter 10 in the 9th verse. It says, why is earth and ashes proud?
Right, why is the earth and ashes proud, man? Speaking of the so-called inhabitants of the earth. You know what I'm saying? Why do you boast yourself against the Heavenly Father? Why do you push philosophies that are against the scriptures? You know what I'm saying? And that's the thing about this place too, man. You know what I'm saying? It's, like it says, give me Isaiah 8:20. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, if you're not speaking according to the scriptures, man, the Lord ain't dealing with you. You know what I'm saying? If you're not quoting the law, that's it. What you do?
Last week, Kimmy.
Oh, okay. Isaiah 8:20.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 8 and the 20th verse.
Right.
To the law and to the testimony, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them.
Right. If you speak not according to this word, man, there is no light in them. There ain't no light in nobody's talking about all nations coming together. You know, for damn sure, the light is not the damn Christian church or the Muslim mosque, man. I'm talking about all men is created equal. Where the hell is that in the scripture, man?
That right there proves that the Lord says that his thoughts are not our thoughts. You know what I'm saying? Because an average man's mind coming together, everybody coming together seems like the right thing to do. But it shows you that the Lord ain't working the same way that we work.
Right.
He has a completely different plan.
Right, man. And that's the point, and that's the problem, and that's the point with all these different nations. They say that, you know, they'll come together, but at the end of the day, outside of our people, every other nation would go back to their own people when, at the end of the day, when it's all said and done. Our people want to stay stuck on stupid, like, you know what I'm saying, just like a bunch of idiots, and want to include all these different nations, want to include the white men, include the damn Arabs. You know what I'm saying? All these different nations. Like it's all, like everything's all cool. Like it's cool, like these nations give a damn about it. You know what I'm saying?